Hey, 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 Moenetics. It's your boy, Tommy Mars, back here with another sort of Morissette episode. So, as you know, Maury, Dave Lamar, got married. Awesome. Congratulations. Very happy to see that. Been seeing pictures and stuff online, and the photos are beautiful. I mean, they're great. And then we had the online digital concert, the 10 Years of Phoenix, which was phenomenal. I don't know if any of you got to see that, but that was top-notch. Everything about that was top-notch. In fact, I'm going to be doing another episode pretty soon here, and I'm going to talk about kind of like my reactions and thoughts from that live performance. But just a quick little snip on that is I thought the production value was outstanding. Everything about it, the look of it, the sound of it, like job super, super well done. I thought it was awesome. But in the meantime, as you know, or hopefully you know, that Maury and Dave dropped a 4-song EP called From the Sea. A lot of people have been dropping in my DM saying, Tommy, have you heard this yet? And I haven't heard it yet. So I'm going to listen to it for the first time with all of you. And to be quite honest with you, I don't know what to expect. I don't know what kind of music it is. All I know is this. Something that involves Maury, I know, is going to be awesome. But even more than that, something that involves Morissette and Dave Lamar has to be greatness, in my opinion, because I think they're both very, very talented artists. So let's get right into it today. This is From the Sea, the EP. Now, the very first song on this is a song called Free. I'm like really excited here because I truly don't know what to expect. I don't know what's coming. So let's go. Oh, I. Oh, peep those harms. Woo. I really like his voice. Right? Oh, man. Oh, I didn't know Dave could sing like that. Whoa. Oh, their arms. Signature Maury. What a signature voice, man. That low register. Great. I love that guitar just hanging out back there. Yeah. I'm trying to hear the guitar solo and I hear Maury laughing. This is awesome. Great song to start this, man. Oh, this is just great chords. Wow, what a vibe. I didn't know what to expect, but I really like the sound of that. I kind of hope the whole record's like that. It's weird because it's a little bit of a chill vibe, but the vocals aren't so chill. There's like some just great, great lines going on there by both of them, by Dave and Morissette. I mean, that's a really good song. And you know what the thing is? That song forces me to go back and I have to do another listen because I was getting lost in that guitar solo, but then I heard Dave and Maury, I heard them laughing and talking like on the other side, so left and right. But that solo that was going on was awesome. I mean, it was awesome. I love the tone of the guitar. In fact, I love the tone of the guitar just in general. Those bring, those nice ring outs. I call it the California tone. It's like the California guitar. That's what that is right there. And I love it. I love the way it sounds. I love the production. I love the rim shot acting as the snare. That is great start. Them dropping this. This is just like, here you go. Here's some songs and it's going to be awesome. Awesome, man. All right, let's go to the next song. And this is called Up and Away. Good sound.
Frightened of the feelings I would get when I stare straight into your eyes. Got me hypnotized, got me floating on air. Avoiding conversations where I would say what's on my mind. Cause you might find out how far I've already fallen.
Oh. Awesome. Yo.
So many doubts since I tried to foresee. Kept telling myself I'm not meant to be. And the day I denied, but night I would pray that these pieces would all fall together one day. And we know we can't have this anymore. Set on a collision course. Your eyes on the whole universe. I wanna go.
I love this mix too. That song needs to be on the next Adam Sandler movie. That is a great song. It's uplifting. It's bright. It's a oh man. And the mix on these songs. Wow. Wow, I really like his voice too.
I've been wandering without your light.
So good. Those drop-in harmonies. Nice lift. Nice. Again. I love that little skip, like. You know what? Two talented individuals like this coming together, recording an album, but being married. I mean, that's a lot of talent in one household, don't you think? I mean, that is, wow. The songwriting on these songs, it's great. I mean, it just flows so nicely with all the while having really, really nice changes and really nice like movements to the songs. This is excellent. I mean, this is giving me those spring summer vibes, man. I'm going to be listening to this thing like all summer long. Wowza. Wow. Dave's voice. I'm a fan. Wow. It's really good. I guess I just didn't know. And they complement each other so well in their call and response, in their harmonies, in his lead. And then you heard those really super wide left and right. Those are like 100-100 on the spectrum, right? Zero, psh, in the middle, 100-100. You got Dave shooting out of the middle with his lead vocal, and then you've got her harmonies pushing left, right, really far out. Sounded 100-100 to me. It's whatever it is, it's amazing. This mix is outstanding. Okay, this last song is called Luna. Last song. I need a whole album of these guys putting out music. I love how bright that acoustic guitar is. Just a great mix. These songs are mixed so well. When the world starts falling apart and everything becomes unstable, when the war starts breaking our hearts and our bodies become unable, there's only one place I every pain and victory. Great tone to his voice up there too.
I'll be here right next to you. I'll know all your fears.
that guitar. Her voice is magic. A lot of musical changes in this song. It's great. Great note. That, my friends, that was a great listen. Wow, I really, really enjoyed that. I have no idea how long they spent on that and really even like putting it together, but it sounds amazing. Their harmonies, they complement each other so well. Those harms, those notes, and right at the end there, I mean, they're like made for each other. I'm talking like in the world, but also in the studio. I mean, it's a perfect match. Yeah, man, that was something else. If I get a chance to speak with Maury, and actually, you know, I already spoke with Maury about the, you know, with the interview, but maybe I need to see about reaching out and getting Dave on a call and talk about his perspective. And all of this, the music and the writing and stuff, man, there's some really great things going on. And actually, in fact, if anybody knows who mixed this, because the mix is, I mean, it is so good. I want to know who mixed it. I want to know who mastered it. I mean, it just sounds so good coming out of my studio monitors here. It's, I mean, the bass frequencies are perfect. Everything about it's perfect. The top end, and there's nothing really escaping, no harshness or nothing. It's just great. It's a great sounding record. Wow. And then I looked at the cover art from the sea. It's simple, but it's effective. It is a great cover. I'm not even kidding you. That's the kind of cover art I like. That's the kind of stuff, personally, on a personal note, that's what I like. And I try to incorporate sometimes some of that into my own stuff when I'm releasing something, because I like it to be a little artsy. And that cover, it's just, I love that. Wow, what a great project, man. I hope we get more of this. I hope this isn't a one-off. I hope we get a lot more material from this. This is a great project. They should keep going on at some point. Maybe I will reach out and see if Dave is available. Man, this is awesome. That was a bad snap. That wasn't good either. I don't have it. All right. It's your boy, Tommy Mars. I will see you next time. Thanks for joining in. Look out soon for a new Maury episode.